Good morning students, welcome to GK classes. Today's class, in this session we are going to deal with a new chapter in our general knowledge, that is defense system. First of all, what is meant by defense system? Okay, the Indian defense system has three services. Okay, Indian Army, Indian Navy and Indian Air Force. Okay, these three services are combinedly called as Indian defense system. Okay, what is meant by Indian defense system? Indian defense system consists of three services. These three services combinedly called as Indian defense system. What are those three services in the Indian defense system? Indian Army, Indian Navy and Indian Air Force. Okay, these three are combinedly called as Indian defense system. Okay, not like that Indian defense system means only Army. Okay, that's the misconception. Clear everyone? Indian defense system has three services: Indian Army, Indian Navy, Indian Air Force. Clear? Then coming to in detail, the President of India is the Supreme Commander of Indian Defense System. Clear? Who is the Supreme Commander of Indian Defense System? Means the President of India. The President of India is the Supreme Commander of Indian Defense System. That means if he is the Supreme Commander of Indian Defense System, means he is the commander of both three services. Now get idea? He is the commander of Indian Defense System means Indian Defense System has three services: Army, Navy and Air Force. That means President of India is the Supreme Commander of all these three services. Clear everyone? That's why if any parade is running, beside the President there are three services walking in front of the President, because he is the Supreme Commander of the defense system. The defense system consists of three services. Clear? Then the whole administration of the Indian defense system was done by the separate ministry, separate department. Okay, that department is Ministry of Defense. Clear? The whole administrative control. Okay, the whole administrative control of Army, Navy, Air Force, three services administrative control was under the ministry, separate department. That department name is Ministry of Defense. Clear everyone? Then coming to, first of all, what? Indian Army. Indian Army. Okay, Indian Army. In India, Indian Army is organized into seven commands. Okay, each command is headed by the, okay, the commander of each command is headed by the general officer commanding in chief of rank, Lieutenant General. Okay, each command in India, army was organized into seven commands at different places. We will discuss later about that seven commands. At present, in India, Indian Army is organized into seven commands at different places in India. In order for the security purpose, Indian Army is organized into seven commands at 7 different places. Each command is headed by the commander in general. Okay, each command is headed by the commander, general officer commanding in chief. That general officer commanding in chief rank was lieutenant general. Lieutenant general is the rank of that officer. Clear? Lieutenant general is the rank of that officer. What is the rank? Lieutenant general. Okay, then the commands, these 7 commands are divided into areas and sub areas. These 7 commands are divided into areas and sub areas. Areas and sub areas. Okay, total these 7 commands are divided into areas. Those areas again divided into sub areas. Okay. Each command was headed by the general officer in commanding with the rank of lieutenant general. And under that commands, these commands are divided into areas. Each area is commanded by major general. Each area is commanded by general officer commanding in the rank of major general. And under that areas, these areas are again divided into sub areas. Okay, sub areas. Sub area is commanded by brigadier. Okay, sub area is commanded by brigadier. Okay, clear everyone? One more time I am going to revise. Indian Army in India, in our country, total in our country. Indian Army is organized into 7 commands, okay, at 7 different places. Each command is headed by the general officer commanding in chief with holding a rank of lieutenant general. That means okoka command ki officer ga evaru untaru ante, okay, okoka command ki officer ga general officer in commanding in chief lieutenant general untaru. Okoka command ki evaru untaru officer? Lieutenant general. These 7 commands, ee 7 commands mari tirigi areas gaanu, aa areas mari sub areas gaanu divided. ఈ యొక్క కమాండ్స్ కింద ఉన్నటువంటి ఏరియాస్కి, ఈచ్ ఏరియాకి హెడెడ్ బై ది కమాండర్ ఇన్ చీఫ్, ఓకే, జనరల్ ఆఫీసర్ ఎవరు అంటే మనకి మేజర్ జనరల్. ఎవరు? మేజర్ జనరల్. అండ్ ఏరియా వాజ్ అగైన్ డివైడెడ్ ఇన్ టు సబ్ ఏరియాస్. దో సబ్ ఏరియాస్ వాజ్ హెడెడ్ బై ద ఆఫీసర్ బ్రిగేడర్. బ్రిగేడర్. In this way, 7 commands are there. Under the commands, areas. Under the areas, sub areas. Each commander was headed by major. His command was headed by lieutenant general. And each area was headed by major general. And each sub area was headed by brigadier. Okay, clear? Then coming to those, what are those 7 commands in the Indian Army? Okay, as you know, in India, divided into North India, South India, East India, West India. Upper part is North India, down portion is South India, our right side portion is East India, left side portion is West India. Likewise, this divided into some areas, and in each area, the Army, Air Force and the Navy established some commands. Command is nothing but one, just like one head office. Okay, each place one head office. Coming to Central Army Command, it is present in Lucknow. Okay, Uttar Pradesh, Lucknow, that is Central Command. That is the main office, main command. Which one? Lucknow. Central Command is in Lucknow. And Eastern Command is in Kolkata, West Bengal. Then northern, only for northern India, northern command is Udhampur. Then for south side, southern command is in Pune. And western command, okay, west side portion was headed by the office, western command, it is in Chandi Mandir. And southwest, okay, southwest, that means south side left portion, southwest command is in Jaipur. And training command for Indian Army, training command is at Shimla. Like that, total Indian Army commands are 7 commands. Central command is in Lucknow, eastern command is in Kolkata, western northern command is in Udhampur, southern command is in Pune, western command is in Chandi Mandir, southwestern command is in Jaipur, and training command is in Shimla. Clear everyone? Then coming to Indian Navy commands. Coming to Navy, that means Navy is in water portion. In India, India is a peninsular country. In India, water is covered by 3 sides. That is east side, west side and south side. That's why we have eastern command, western command and southern command. Eastern command is in Mumbai. Sorry, western command is in Mumbai. Okay, Mumbai, Maharashtra, Mumbai. Then eastern command is in Visakhapatnam. Okay, east side in Andhra Pradesh, Visakhapatnam, eastern command. And southern command is in Kochi, Kerala, Kochi. In this way, 3 naval commands are there. Then coming to Air Force commands, Indian Air Force commands. This Indian Air Force commands, Central Air Force Command is in Allahabad, Eastern Air Force Command is in Shillong, Southern Air Force Command is in Thiruvananthapuram, Western Command is in New Delhi, Southwestern Command is in Gandhinagar, Training Command is in Bengaluru, then Maintenance Command is in Nagpur. In this way, total Indian Air Force commands are there. And one more thing most important is, up to now we had discussed all these commands of Indian Army, Indian Navy and Indian Air Force. Now for maintaining and for administrating and for governing all these 3 commands, Indian Army, Indian Navy and Indian Air Force, for all these 3 there is one tri-services command. Tri-services command means total 3 services, one head office. It is in Andaman and Nicobar Island at Port Blair. Most important, tri-services command is in Andaman and Nicobar Islands at Port Blair. Okay, this is about defense system. Okay, we just discussed some introduction portion and some static portion, which you have to keep it in mind, which you have to memorize continuously. You have to do revision again and again in order to memorize these places. Okay, most important, sometimes they are direct questions asking, like where is Eastern Army Command is present, Kolkata, like that static questions are also asking from this topic. Okay, you have to go through this video and write down the information clearly without any spelling mistakes. And if you have any doubts and any clarifications regarding this topic, we will discuss in live sessions, okay, live class sessions. Okay, please pause this video and write down the information. Thank you so much. Have a nice day.